What's up, guys? Raz here, and today we're here with part two of our Biome Hopper series. Yay! Last episode we were in the jungle, and this episode I decided, why not move on to the Nether? The Nether's awesome. It's a place where your dreams come true, except not really, because you're always getting hit by ghasts and pigmen. But that's not the point. Point being here that we're in the Nether, and with the Nether comes new blocks. I decided I wanted to experiment to see what kind of blocks I wanted to put around the edges. And I even tried furnaces, because in the past I have made houses with furnaces on the floor, and it actually looked good. I mean, you know, you might be judging me right now, but I liked it. At any rate, so I continued making this. I decided in the end it'd probably just be best if I just use netherrack, and then obsidian or endstone also looks good. I am using the Aetherus Ascended texture pack in particular, and you're supposed to use it with this map. Like, you have to, or else it doesn't work. But, yeah, this map actually is based upon the texture pack. Also, because I don't think I mentioned this, this is supposed to be played in creative mode, and no other mode, because you might die. Actually, you will die, come to think of it. Not just might. So, continuing here, I wanted to keep the arrow theme. In the past, I've made like the arrows that point to where you're supposed to be jumping to, the next platform is. And so I kept that theme with the endstone and netherrack, and made these lava falls just for ambience, you know. It's just something cool to look at. I wanted the Nether to have something like, you know, I wanted each biome to have something pretty distinctive. And in this biome, I wanted there to be just, you know, just these wacky parkour things that you have to do. So right here you have to jump down really far, which is, you know, I think that dropping down really far kind of fits with the idea of the Nether being on the ground, and so that's kind of why I did it. Then I skipped ahead some after I made this brilliant parkour area where you have to jump across these blocks, and they're kind of spaced apart. This is like the somewhat hard area, and I decided to make it this way so there's more than one way you can go. I kind of wanted that to be like a somewhat theme of my map. Being able to go more than one way. And over here I made a gold platform and started work on this. This was the makings of an amazing soul sand thing. The idea was that, because I had an idea in my mind, I was thinking, you know what, you can't really do the Nether without soul sand. So what did I do? I added in a soul sand like pathway that you have to run through. And there's obsidian, or endstone, actually, throughout it. So it's a mixture between soul sand and obsidian, not obsidian, endstone, and then air blocks. So you see I typed in here, I messed it up a few times, but eventually I got it working. Basically, I made it like, I don't remember the exact percentage, but it was like a 20% chance that it would be air, 20% chance it would be endstone, and then the 60% chance that any block that I use in world edit would be the soul sand. So there's like a cool variance on this pathway that was arching around to your next destination. And I didn't want it to be like a straight line, so I broke it up some and moved it around some. And over here, I finished up with it. And yeah, I added more archway, more holes and everything. And like I said, this is supposed to be played in creative, so if you do miss, then, you know, that's why. Over here I wanted to build another area, it's going to be the final area, where I kind of wanted something to do with lava, because I was thinking, you know, it is the end. It's not the end, actually. It is the Nether, and, you know, you can't really do the Nether without having lava. That's just not the Nether. What is this place? And it'd be like the overworld, except red. Anyways, I decided, you know what? I'm going to put the lava room. Because I couldn't think of anything else to do. Okay, I did this pretty much like on the spot. I never really thought about what I wanted the map to be like beforehand. I just kind of did it on the spot. And for the most part, that's helped. But I'll be honest, sometimes it kind of hurt. Sometimes it kind of hurt some. But that's okay. Because we learn and we thrive. I'm not sure if that's a quote from anyone. I don't care either. Anyways, so this area is the lava room. It's not a lava room without lava, though, and finally I add in the lava. Eventually, I just started out with placing lava randomly, but eventually I realized, you know what, why not just make everything lava and there's only a few blocks you can jump on? Yeah, that sounds better. And so I did that, And yeah, that actually is pretty much it. And at the end there, the area, there is the portal. I put it in. And let's go to the pan over. Panning over our first area where we jump down through the lava falls onto these little jumpy pad things. And up to the gold block and onto our soul sand area thing. And yeah, that's about it. I am in the lava room. That's about it. And I'll talk to you guys later. Peace out.